na Univerzite Institutu Physics, and today my talk is a short trip to the Kerr black hole or numerical simulation of view of the star universe observers in the Kerr field. So this is outline. I would like to say something about motivation, and then I will very briefly discuss some prerequisites and machinery which we need to construct optical projection in the Kerr field. So I will say something about photon motion in the Kerr field, and finally about the construction of the optical projection. And then I would like to present two cases of simulations. In the first case, we'll show some sky of static observers which are in the rest with respect to infinity or with respect to coordinate frame. And in the case two, I would like to present sky of some observers. This is observers which are dragged by space time rotation. And then I will say something about our plan for the future. So, the task is to construct a view of distant universe on sky for observers in the close vicinity of Kerr black hole. What is the close vicinity? I mean, the observer which is near the photosphere of the black hole, very close, but inside the ergosphere, and almost located almost just on the horizon, of the hole. And this is really the task of virtual astronomy. This is not testable experimentally or in the present and near the future, but there is some reason why to do it. The first such task can give some intuitive insight into properties of the strongly curved seismic space-time. Not only mathematical view, but some intuitive insight. And there are some aesthetic reasons why to do it. The pictures is really interesting, and maybe the pictures have some aesthetic qualities. And of course, such simulation can be used in promotion of astrophysics to the public. I would like to say that the simulation originated a side effect of the numerical modeling of fluxes of oscillated torii, which such simulation of fluxes of torii will be presented by Kateřina Bouková in today afternoon session. So, I would like to say something about machinery which we used for the simulation, and about application for the construction to optical projection. Yeah, something about prerequisites. So we use the Kerr metric in the classical and standard borderless coordinate with such coefficients. For description of for photon's trajectory, we use the component of four momentums given by Carter and Chandrasekhar. For instance, I would like to say that the Gresham role play the first and second equation for radial and optical motion, and sign of this motion. In the here you can see the form of radial and latitudinal potentials, and the crucial property is that the photon motion can be separated in the radial and latitudinal part in such potentials, and the trajectory of the photon depends only on two constants of motion by Chandrasekhar, Kerr, character, and of course with some initial condition on the observer screen, but on the end of an emission. So the first, we'll briefly discuss the properties of radial motion. The properties of radial motion. You can see that the square root of the radial potential can give three qualitatively different behavior. And the first, for a given pair of lambda and q of constant motion, we can have two separated regions of photo motion, one from infinity to outer turning point, and the second one above originating on the horizon, and turning point. So such photons can travel from infinity to the turning point, and such photons are returning back to infinity. And the second case is geodesic without turning points, and such photons can travel directly from infinity to the horizon, the ergosphere, the spherical photosphere of the black hole. And the critical limit case is corresponds to capturing the photon just on the spherical photon orbit, unstable photon orbits. And this is some difference between the spherical symmetric spacetimes and the Kerr spacetimes, because photosphere of the Kerr black hole is not just sphere, but is such shape. It is very thin on the polar axis, and such photosphere has maximal extension just on the equatorial plane, which is given by location of the counter-rotating and rotating circular photo orbit. And another unstable photo orbit in the photosphere is not circular, but spherical, for instance, such shape. So the space-time dragging make such shape of the photon orbit, which are captures on the unstable position on the potential, which is where the potential touching the zero. The properties of material motion is more simply because generally there are two possibilities how the photon can oscillate between the turning points in a particular sense. For second Carter constant Q greater than zero, greater than zero, the photon can oscillate between the two symmetric turning points above and under the equatorial plane. And for Q is more than zero, we have two separate regions of the motion, so such photons cannot reach across the equatorial plane. And of course, such photons can make many loops between such turning points. This is the difference between the radial and the particular motion, because in the radial case, the photon can pass only one times through the turning points, and then the photon mass return to infinity or fall back to the horizon. So this is construction of the observer screen using projection of local component. And for generally, the direction of the source in the sky is given by tangent vector to the trajectory. This is of course for momentum, and we have local component normalized to one, and a projection of such momentum in the screen, we obtain theta and phi component, which corresponds to the position of the observer sky. And of course, to compute global component, one have to project such local component using theta or one form of observer frame into the global component F. So I have direct connection between position of the observer screen using such equation and parameters lambda and q, constant motion of the photon, and then by some definition relation. And then I have initial condition on the observer screen, constant motion, and the software can make direct interaction of the photon trajectory. We use the code LSD plus. This is general parallel tracer and visualizer for cat spacetime. Develop it and test it in our institute. We use such ray tracing for the ray tracing. We use the Runge-Kutta adaptive method of the order, so Dorman price method, which the high integration accuracy about 10 up to minus 14 in geometrical units. So we can integrate the trajectories for stellar space times, for instance, for m is equal to 10 solar masses in accuracy better than millimeters. This is very good result. And because of construction of the code, we can process unlimited order of images. So there is no restriction for the loops around the black holes. The integration is independent from the observer frame, so we can process the different observer frames, or integration for different observers. We can set arbitrary resolution of the observer screen, arbitrary position, and radial electrical sense for observer. We can set, we can restrict integration to some part of observer sky. We process, of course, frequency shift, which is modeled as the color change of distance sources. We can compute critical curves and angular amplification. And finally, now, we have implemented static and zero momentum observers. We are preparing the different observers, for instance, energy falling and geometric orbiting observers. But now, two frames are implemented and tested. I would like to show results for two frames. So this is something called simulation setup. We have two pictures of the virtual non-distorted observer sky. This is front hemisphere towards to the black hole, and back hemisphere there is some Saturn-like planet with some rings. So here's an observer which is very near of some planets and looking in the space and observing the, such a galaxy. This, I think, is Andromeda galaxy, and our model of the black hole is near the extreme Kerr black hole of spin 0.995 m, which corresponds to even horizon on 1.031 m, and equatorial photo orbit are located on 0.9 m and 1.037 m. So this is set up for all simulation, which I would like to present here. First case simulation will be rooted to static observers. As I said, the static observers are in the rest with the respect to coordinate frame, with the respect to observer in the rest. Infinity. Angular velocity observer is zero, and this is corresponding to frame theta one form for transforming of global component of momentum. Such observers as some restriction exist above L2 space only because of frame dragging, and we perform the simulation for observers located on the equatorial plane. This is the result. This is observer. This is sky. The first observer located on 10m. We can observe the front hemisphere and backward hemisphere, and we can observe the typical shape of black hole silhouette for the Kerr black hole. And what is interesting that the frame dragging, shifting. Image of second order of the opposite part of the sky on the left side of the picture of the image, and interesting this angular separation between images of high order in the such part of the sky is significantly greater than in Schwarzschildian case, so the frame dragging some boosting of the separation of the images. We can go into detail. I think this is better visible. This is the first image, direct image, second direct image, and you can observe the second direct image, second direct image, and so on. And this is for comparison. This is some picture. Similar simulation for Schwarzschildian case, and you can see the general angular separation of the high order images is small. In fact, the high order images merge into some circle around the photosphere of the hole. This is really the difference between the Schwarzschildian case. You can go deeply into detail. And you can see some focus or zoom of images on high order. You can see first undirect, second undirect, and so on. And this is the border of the area. This is a really This is a border of the images corresponds to border of photosphere. This is just image of photo orbit just on the border of the dark and radiant area of the screen. So there is some quantities of projection. In the first picture, you can see the transformation of the radius, the radial coordinate on the distant sky. You can see that the zero, almost zero radius, correspond to some first engineering. You can see very well the shifting of the projection on the left side, such part. This is almost the same. This is the amplification and critical curves, which correspond to caustics of the projection. And in this picture, we can see the image order, first, second, and so on. And in the second picture, you can see the radial turning point. Interesting is that the interpretation of the observer sky, of static observers, is clear. in the front view, front hemisphere, the border of the hemisphere, or the main circle connecting to nadir and zadir, correspond for geodesic, which has the turning point just on the observable position. So all geodesics falling on the front hemisphere, approaching the observer from the turning points which are located in the position corresponding such scale. Of course, geodesic from the back hemisphere falling down directly without passing the turning points to the observer position. Now we will go deeply in the Kerr field, but still as the static observer. So we are observing static and such radial direction, radial position. And this is the simulation above the photosphere, above the spherical photo orbit region. You can see that the black part of black region or silhouette or a shadow of the hole is expanding, and just on the border of photosphere, just on the location of co-rotating photo orbit, the shadow of the hole touching the main circle of the main circle of the observer sky. This is nothing else than the turning point of such geodesic in the main circle. It's just on the regular coordinate on the rotating photo orbit. And of course, it's dependent on the declination, but just here, this location corresponding to capturing such photon on the qualitative photon orbit. On the picture below, you can see a distortion of the hemisphere. You can see some shifting of the part of image in the back hemisphere. And now we will go to or inside the spherical photo on the region. The shadow of the hole is still expanding. And part of the shadow is shifted in the opposite part of the sky of the observer. So, generally the shining or radiating part of the sky, which corresponds to all objects in the universe, is smaller and smaller. Very close to the static limit. Static limit is the limit of existence of the static observer. All projection of the object on the sky is shifted in the back hemisphere, and just under static limit, the projection of all the lens is very small. But of course, just under static limit, the projection of the lens will be only small radiating spot. Of course, with infinitely blue shifted. And this is some picture about the behavior of the silhouette and shadow of the black hole. We are starting from 10 m. With decreasing the radial coordinate, the shadow is growing, shift, the sword is shifted in the opposite part of the sky and ending in a small point in such position of the opposite hemisphere of the sky. I would like to say that the sword is really projection of the boundary of the photosphere. So if one will observe some radiation inside the sword, inside the shadow of the Blood Moon, this is radiation which must originate somewhere between horizon and the photosphere. Okay. The second case is simulation for some observers. Some observers are observed with zero angular momentum. These observers are in the constant regular connect, but they are dragged by rotation of space-time, so by flat dragging, by such omega, and corresponding frame theta waveform takes such form. The R and theta component are the same as in the previous case, but there is some difference in the T component and the phi component. Generally, the observers are boosted in the phi direction with respect to the static frame. The advantage is that such observers exist everywhere above the given horizon, so we can make simulation which is really near or just on the even horizon of the black hole, and such simulation was performed as in the previous case for observers located on the equatorial plane. So this is first set of result. We can see that for relatively higher radial coordinate, the picture, the results are very similar or comparable to a static case. This is clear because the omega grows with the approaching of the hole, so omega is relatively small in such coordinates. So the effects are similar. There is some small modification in the frequency shift of the projection of the core of the distant object. And now, but when the observer is located in the spherical photo orbit region, the result are significantly different. At the first, because of boost in the phi direction, we can observe some effect, Doppler effects in the colors of the projection. And the omega together with frame dragging boosts the angular separation of the high order images. You can see that the angular separation is greater than previous case. And of course, the distortion of the back hemisphere, back part of the projection is different. Is different or significantly greater than in the static case. For observers, we are located in close vicinity of the horizon, just on the horizon, very small. We can see that qualitative properties of character of the projection is really different. At the first image is smallest one. This is the first image. And the angular separation grows. Of course, angular magnitude of the images grows with all the images. So this is the first image, second one, third one, and so on and so on. And of course, because of high velocity of lip dragging, the Doppler effects are very good visible. You can observe two cases. The first case is observer located on R1.5m. This is observer still in the photosphere. So such projection touching the main circle of the sky, and some part of projection is still in the front hemisphere of the sky. The second case is observer located slightly under the photosphere, and slightly, of course, above the horizon. You can see that the projection volume is somewhat compressed in the sun. Interesting shape. And it is not very good visible, but there is no touch point with the main circle of the sky of such observer. This is some bonus. This is observer which is located just on the pole, very near to the horizon. This is an observer too. And you can see the effect of distortion of the sky by frame dragging. So the dragging of the space-times somehow destroying, curving some image of the distant object. As in the previous case, this is evolution of the shape of the black hole silhouette or shadow for relatively high radar coordinates. The behavior is similar to the static case, but if the observer will go deeply in the small R, you can see that comparing the previous case, the bigger part of the projection is shifted in the opposite hemisphere of the sky, and for a really smaller R, so it's a little slightly above the horizon, you can see the shape of the projection is very different. I would like to stress that in the opposite hemisphere, the projection is inside such curves, not outside as here. So because the shape is growing, some part is shifted in the opposite hemisphere, and the projection of the whole universe is inside such curves. So to return, such projection, such shape corresponds to such curve. Okay, this is our result with implementation of optical projection in the Kerr field. And what we are planning for tomorrow is implementation of different observer frames, especially earlier free-falling observers, maybe the geodesically orbiting Keplerian observers. And what we are working now is the implementation not for only for computer thing, for some virtual reality devices, for instance, for 3D glasses. Okay.